Okay.
Announcer Ralph.
We'll be getting going very, very soon. Doing final audio checks. Folks, this is John Maddening from the Minnesota Roller Girls for DNN here at RollerCon. If I repeat myself, it's because we are unsure if that audio went out. We are just a few minutes away from the beginning of this bout between Denver and Rose City. Both of these teams playing two games this weekend. Rose City lost to Philly at noon today by about 150 points, so big tough loss for them. And they're playing their second and final game right now. And then Denver, after this, will play Minnesota at noon tomorrow. All these times, of course, are Pacific time, which is Greenwich Mean at 7 for all you international folks. But as soon as we get the word from refs, we will get going here for you. I'll be joined by Val Capone. And this is a huge, huge RollerCon this year. Nearly, I'm told, almost 6,000 attendees. So over double last year's attendance. It's been working out really fantastic here at the Riviera. Just about everything is under one roof, or, you know, out in the outdoor pool and all. There are lines for hours for the classes taught by some of the best players in the sport. And there's a lot of learning going on here. It's really fantastic to see a lot of newer skaters, newer leagues coming and learning from folks that have been out for a while. So once again, we will get started in just a few moments.
You're ready to do leave anyway.
Ladies and gentlemen, you are about to witness a very important bout here at RollerCon. As Rose City takes on Denver. Should be a great matchup, so buckle your seatbelts and get ready to rock and roll here at RollerCon. I'm Rockus Ron.
Hello? Hey, there I am. And this is Tara Armand.
Denver right now getting their safety check from the refs. Let's just go through the rosters to begin with. For the Wheels of Justice from beautiful Portland, Oregon. Number 100, Mercy. 11, Kickacity. Number 17, 19, Skill the Devourer. Silent Devourer. Number 17, H, The Blast Unicorn. Number 21, Untamed Shrew. Number 210, Heidi Go Seek. Number 28, Minstrel Psycho. Number 360, Joyride. Number 47, Penny Dreadful. Number 5, Mel Mangles. Number 66, Brady Punch. Number 73, Frank and Herder. Number 81, Havana Good Time. And number 94, Scrappy Go Lucky. Wheels of Justice are in the purple. Rose City Rollers, purple and white accents, black helmets. And as for the 52, no, not the Mile High Club, it's another term for mile, I suppose, from the Denver Rolling Dolls, number 19, Julie Adam, number 1982, Ariel Quigley, number 20, Monica Carson, number 24, Sandrine Rangon, number 28, Chrisanna Barrett, number 303, Heather Juskin, number 307, Shana Sorelson, number 357, November James, number 4, Jess Rivas, number 617, Tara Kish, number 719, Amanda Sharpless, number 831, S.H. Long, number 9, Volt, Vicky Cruz, and number 99, Tracy Akers. Looks like we got Juska on the line for Denver. And number 5, Mel Mangles for Rose City. Again, Denver in white, Rose City in purple.
Quick start, first jam.
Quick start to the first jam. Here we go through. And a quick run through. Mel Mangles gets lead jammer for Rose City immediately. Looks like we had a false start. So she's going to be going through a little middle minor. Oh, takes a bit of a tumble, just does. Gets right back up and re-enters the back of the pack. Trying to get through that Rose City wall there. Brought down one, brought down two. Pack tries to reform in front of her. Goes around the outside, round the outside. Picks her up. Sorry, folks, a little bit of audio display here. We've got a bit of audio problems, but we will get to you very shortly. Very sorry, Willie. Notice that you do have the video, of course.
Again, the no-pack technique of getting your jammer out, very popular this weekend at RollerCon.
Just getting run through and finally does have to be let through. Picks up five. As Scrappy Go Lucky hits the box. Mel Mangles, a nice side cut through there by number 99, Tracy Disco Akers. Cuts her down and slows her down. Jessica has made it through for another 5 points. So just when we thought that Rose was going to run away with that amazing jump off the track there, Denver actually picked up 15 points to Rose City's zero.
And it looks like Amanda Sharpless is next on the line for Denver. Can't quite see who the Rose jammer is because Rob Lobster is out there trying to protect his ladies and blocking my view. But we do have zero on the scoreboard for Rose City and 15 for Denver with 27 minutes and 34 seconds left. It's already an official timeout, John Maddening.
That's true. They're having a bit of a confab, but the skaters are taking it in stride. The wheels of justice, big smiles on their faces. And we are about to begin again.
That was a nice short official timeout. It was almost as long as the 30 seconds period in between jams.
Always like them when they're short.
Yes. So that's the Blast Unicorn. That is 17H jamming for Wheels of Justice.
Become your lead jammer for Denver. A quick run through on her scoring pass and picks up five.
Picked up a nice 5 points. Looks like Blast Unicorn is finally through. Had to readjust her wrist guards for a moment there, Maddening.
Amanda Sharpless. One more attempt through here. Getting a low, we'll get a little help there from Celia. I'm sorry, from Ariel Quigley. But goes down and calls it.
We have number 21, Untamed Shrew in purple for Wheels Justice.
And Sandrine Rajon for the Mile High Club. That I'm doing the French names properly.
I'm going to go with Sandrine is what I'm going to call her to be on the safe side.
In favor of Denver.
And there's one skater for each team in the penalty box, but now the blocker from Portland is standing as Denver gets out of the pack and gets lead jammer for Denver Roller Dolls.
Run through there. And Rose City is, almost. Nothing to do, but Untamed Shrew is finally
Tracy
through
Akers.
The pack.
Tracy Akers just doing a number on her, Maddening.
A nice, nice move there. They're playing very defensively. Very good job here. We are not going to get another pass. 4 points at the end. It's going to bring them up to 27. Rose City 2, 25-40 remaining.
Mel Mangles lined up for the Wheels of Justice, number 5 in purple on the outside of the jam line.
She's making her second jamming appearance.
It looks like Heather Juska.
Juska, yeah.
Yep. What's a Juska?
Oh, exactly the opposite as the first time this happened. This time Juska just jumps out and grabs it, but Mel Mangles hot on her skates, about a half track behind.
All of Rose at front of the pack trying to avoid their points being scored upon, but Heather Juska just barrels her way through, spins around, calls a jam. I believe she picked up 4 points on that pass, John.
I believe that's absolutely right. She jutted out her hips to make sure that they were in front of the frontmost blocker to make sure to pick up that last point.
The Blast Unicorn is lining up on the outside again for Rose. Not quite sure who the jammer is for Denver. I do apologize.
I think that's Amanda Sharpless.
Her long, luxurious locks are blocking her name and number on her back, so we apologize.
You'll have to excuse us, folks. We are at a very odd angle here, but we'll do our very best to give you the action as it occurs. The Last Unicorn really having trouble at the back of the pack as Denver breaks it through. And yes, that is 719 Amanda Sharpless, your lead jammer for Denver. Last Unicorn trying to pour on the speed, trying to catch up, seeing if she can do anything. And Sharpless gets bumped around a bit, but still manages to pick up a few points. So Denver increases their lead. Rose City's now still at 2. Denver at 34, just under 23 minutes remaining in the first half.
There she is, my Denver wife, Julie Adams, number 19th, also known as Angela Death. And it looks like she's facing off against, is that 71?
I believe that's Untamed Shrew, number 21.
Oh, thank you, number 21.
Adams now pushing on Mercy and Heidi Goseek.
Can run, a nice little push out there. But all it did is slow down. No, it didn't, a major cut on number 19, Julie Adam. So she's going to go sit down. Oh.
Well, look like this. It looks like there's going to be another, a block with the head.
A little do-si-do action here. So Julie Adam rejoins. And very quickly, so will Rose.
Julie Adams crashing through, takes down. And she's going to get a major back block. Unfortunately, Julie can't seem to get a break on this jam.
It's kind of the jammer do-si-do in and out of the box here. Untamed Shrew now in the power jam. One more Denver skater to beat. Gets on through and finally can begin her scoring pass. But this jam has 48 more seconds to go here. No lead jammer. Shrew goes down in the middle of the pack, jumps back up, tries to figure a way out to get through. They're doing actually a 2-2 separated here, but it's very effective. They can concentrate both on the jammer and on breaking up that Rose pack. So Denver's doing an excellent, excellent job of defense here.
Denver's garbage is very effective on the defense.
Untamed Shrew just having a rough, rough time. The entire Denver pack is reformed in front, and Julie Adam has come out of the box and ends up no points for her. 3 points for Rose City. So Rose City now at 7 on that last after that last pass. Denver still at 34, 21 minutes to go. So lining up now for Wheels of Justice again, number five, Mel Mangles. And number 24, Sandrine. We have Mel Mangles as your lead jammer for Rose City. This is the break that Rose City really needs. Sandrine, about two-thirds of a pack behind her. Mel Mangles making her way through. Looks like picks up three. Rose City at 9, Denver at 34. So this is what Rose needs to do, kind of chip away at that lead. 20 minutes to go. Looks like we've got Juska up on the line for Denver. Last unicorn for Rose City. Rose City's pivots out. That's number 360, Joyride. And there she goes. We have another Denver lead jam.
Well, hey there, John Manning.
Oh, can you hear me now?
I can hear
Fantastic.
You now.
Fantastic. Our audio problems are over. If there was any wood to knock on here, I would totally do so.
I'm knocking on my own skull right now.
Juska goes again. There she goes. Big 5 points there. And re-enters again in her next attempt. And goes out. So that's certainly not good.
John, I got to point out that the Blast Unicorn is actually sent to the penalty box. Looked like she had a major track cut. She thought that the blocker that knocked her out of bounds actually went out with her, but she did not.
So it's a 30-point game right now. Denver at 39. Rose at 9. 18:40 to go in the first half. And we have a timeout charged to Rose City.
So thanks for bearing with us, folks. We had a little bit of technical difficulty. Lost all ability to hear John Manning. And because there are quite a few people here, as you can see, it's pretty deafening in here when the game is actually happening. That combined with the fact that we do have two full tracks going at the same time meant I could hear nothing. So I felt it better to not talk very much at all, which maybe some people out there are very glad about that. And I don't blame you.
So Rose here, of course, is without a couple of key players. White Flight had a knee injury.
Yeah, Scald Eagle hurt herself at ECDX, although I don't recall what it was.
I believe that was a broken leg, was it?
Oh boy!
I don't want to come out and
let's
say
not
that for
speculate.
Certain,
let's say that she unfortunately sustained a injury that's going to bench her for a little while.
Yep.
And then also sulfuric acid. Not sure where she is. Used to seeing her with this lineup,
yes.
And I'm not seeing her this weekend, unfortunately. But, you know, this is after rankings come out, so this shouldn't hurt Portland too much, so long as they can realize that it was a learning experience.
Oh,
they
absolutely.
Did what they could with the roster that they had. And also, it's a good pointer outer to everyone that relies on one or two, sometimes three jammers. You need to have your whole team locked and loaded, ready to go. Or at least more than one or two, you know, stand-up jammers. Not that, stand-out jammers, rather, because they do have quite a few stand-up jammers in Portland. There's a lot of girls that will get the job done. I mean, Mel Mangles is one of those skaters that she is really good when she jams, but she is really great when she's in the pack. So skaters like that. However, Joyride has been doing quite good this weekend. I mean, I think so.
And all five of these teams that are participating in this little round robin we have going on here are a little bit different than we've seen them in the past. Key players are missing. The only exception here being Philly, who really seem to come and just want to dominate this. There's no real winner in this tournament. Nobody's going for a golden cup at the end, but Philly has just been on a tear.
I'm actually going to disagree with you and say that everyone is going for a golden cup at the end of RollerCon in the pool. They're going to be drinking a lot. Because I know a lot of girls from all these WFTDA sanctioned bout teams did not participate in any activities because of this. Oh, what is that crowd? Are you saying you don't enjoy roller derby where nobody moves? Oh, weird. Denver stays back on the jam line. Rose trying to bridge, but there's not much you can do after a certain point. Lead jammer status gets awarded to 719. That's Amanda Sharpless, excuse me.
Sharpless now up at the front on that wall, that Rose City wall. She tried to go to the outside, now tries to cut around the inside. Peeled one off, and then they had to let her go as Denver had slowed the pack down enough to split them up a bit. No bridge was available for her.
Wow, there's a big tumble out there. No back block call, though. That's, you know, don't blame them. We don't have an exact view from over here, but you got to remember there's that whole line along your shoulder that you completely can make contact with.
Absolutely.
5 points picked up on that last pass, Manning.
Trying to go through for another, put the dot on that eye that he come around. Round through the turn two, having a little bit of trouble there with those two Rose City blockers. That was Heidi Go Seek with a great job of just kind of staying on or getting her, kind of digging her shoulder into her.
Yeah, and now the Blast Unicorn is actually on the track and in the middle of the pack, has one blocker left at the top of the pack, but that blocker is Tracy Akers. She gets past Akers, and Sharpless is already back racking up some points.
So we'll see what happens as she tries to get past these all four Rose blockers here. Calls it off just as the Unicorn comes to the end, comes to the back of the pack, calls it off, and now Rose City remains at 9, Denver up to 58, 16:50 remaining in the first half.
Tight formation on that jam line. Sandrine Rangon, is that how you say it?
Sandrine Rangon?
So my lady, SR, that's how I say it, word.
She's going to pop me in the mouth somewhere.
She's going to pop me in the mouth, I guarantee it.
Nice looking scrum start. Oh, and Denver runs through around the inside there. Sandrine gets the lead jam. And already two-thirds of the way around and ready to make her initial scoring pass here.
Mel Mangles still fighting through the mists of silver and blue. Sandrine is in and out of the pack with the quickness and also 5 points.
Broke through the two on the in the rear. Looks like Rose was trying to that 2-2 that Denver was doing so well with earlier. Didn't work quite work out for him.
Back one again.
Wow. Nice moves there.
That was only 4 points, though, because Mel Mangles was already at the back of the pack, ready to score. Jam got called before that could happen. 9 still on the board for Rose City, 67 for Denver.
15 minutes, 30 seconds remaining in this first half. And folks, if you are seeing all this RollerCon action, and there's tons more that you don't see. There's a billion challenge bouts that are going on 3 different tracks, as well as 4 learning tracks. You sure want to come here next year. You want to check it out? Also, however, oh, nice push. She goes out as well. But a low block major is going to send Juska to the box here. Once again, it's time for Rosetti to try and capitalize on this. And Rose gets lead jammer status. There's a moment there, she's looking like, am I going to call it off? Am I going to try to get another one started? But nope. She's going to try and go. She's noticed there's 2 blockers for Denver in the box. They have a total minivan situation, and they are using it. Grand slam for Rose City. Full power for Rose City. Only 2 blockers out for Denver right now. And they're split up. Ange gets by. Very, very nice move there.
Nice work by the Wall of Purple, isolating a Denver skater at the back of the pack.
And Untamed Shrew calls it off. It resets. And it looks like Blast Unicorn is going to be out here. And they're going to start off with Dwell.
Yeah, there's a full box. It's a super mega ultra power jam is what I like to call it for Denver. The wheels of justice gathering up to decide what exactly will they be doing on this jam. Getting that jam underway is exactly what they should do.
There they go.
Last unicorn gets through, and she gets out. Hopefully, Wheels of Justice will realize that the jammer is standing in the box for Denver.
And as she's released, Denver kind of reforms there. Blast Unicorn trying to get around the outside. Oh,
nice. Almost takeout, but Sharpless, that's Jessica, stays up on her feet. Blast is out now. She picks up the points and decides to call the jam.
Smart move.
Very smart move, because Jessica was almost at the back of the pack.
Another 4 points added. Pardon me, another 5 points added to Rose's. And they are at 24. Denver is at 67, just under 13 minutes in this first half. Remember, folks, the final game of this round robin will be tomorrow at noon Pacific time. That'll be Denver versus Minnesota.
Oh, Denver versus Minnesota.
It's true.
Very excited to see that.
They haven't faced each other since summer of 2008. At the Fillmore, when they were still skating at the Fillmore.
Oh, wow, really?
Yeah.
Nice.
And pretty much completely different teams.
Yeah, well, actually, there's still a few
few outliers.
Julie Adams
yep,
is still there.
But there's a lot of fresh faces on both these teams, and it's going to be a completely different outcome. And it might be a completely different outcome as what we see in the Big Five, too. So
yeah, that's true.
This is a weird place for Derby. It's a weird surface for a lot of people.
Well, yes and no. I mean, I've talked to a lot of people about it. Of course, I'm not skating this week, unfortunately, but I've talked to a lot of the skaters that I've been bench coaching, and some of them have said that they absolutely love it. Look at Mel Mangles was just showing she was very excited about it. Some people did complain that it was a little too slippery, but you know, we have an amazing track crew that got right out there and did what they could to clean it up, make sure it's dusted off, cleaning it up as often as they can. A lot of people are okay skating on this sport court. It's not skate court, it's a little bit different. It's what, like, the old school days, back in the ye old days of the first dust devil. Before a strategy was truly involved in roller derby, when it was our jammers are fast, our blockers are big, you sort out the rest, kind of roller derby.
Yeah. So we got sport court on top of plywood on top of hotel carpeting.
Yes. So. And there's actually, I believe, mats underneath the plywood as
well.
Oh,
yeah.
Trying to hold her out, but no, she gets through. Lead jammer is number 5, Mal Mangles, the Chuck Norris of roller derby.
And Sharpless for Denver, still stuck in the pack. Recycled to the back. He's going to make another strike here. Oh, Mel Mangles runs right into the elbow of Sharpless and knocks her down. Maybe it was the upper arm, but again, that perfectly legal blocking area.
26 on the board for Rose City. She did get 1 point before she called the jam. Looks like it kind of knocked the wind out of her a little bit.
Yeah.
I say good call, Mel, because you know what? They're going to be utilizing her a lot, wearing the star, in the pack, all over the place. Don't kill your energy right now. You've got a lot of legs out there that are ready to skate.
Untamed True, number 21 in the purple for the Wheels of Justice, up against number 24 in the white, Sandrine Rajon, for the Mile High Club.
Oh, look at that with a quickness. Sneaky, sneaky. Getting lead jammer for Rose City. That's number 21, Untamed Shrew. She was undetected Shrew on that last pass. And Sandrine is now out. But look at Shrew is right at the back of the pack, getting a little bit of assistance from her wall of purple.
I believe she got a minor low block in there as well, so she's got to watch her minor penalties.
210, Heidi Goseek is going to seek out a seat in the penalty box.
And Shrew calls it off.
I keep wanting to call her Wreckin' Shrew because my teammate in Chicago, her name is Wreckin' Shrew. So Untamed Shrew, Untamed Shrew.
All right, so Denver still at 67. Rose at 29 with 10 minutes 40 seconds remaining in the first half.
And the Blast Unicorn is lining up once again for Rose City.
Up against Jessica for the Mile High Club. And there we go. Jessica says, I am still here, and we are still Denver. Gets on through, grabs lead jam and she's going through before Rose even gets through the first time, and scores 5 right there. 5 big roller derby points. Heather Jessica. having a bit of trouble there. Blast Unicorn is finally to one. Oh, goes down.
Yeah, that's a big takeout from the front blocker, number 357, November James. More like November Pains.
Almost got through, got knocked around. Oh, she is bouncing around like a pachinko ball in there, holding her face now.
But I like that she shook it off. She was not happy about it, and then she literally just and shook it off.
Grabbing a hold of, I believe, Frankenherter and pushing her through as a battering ram, trying to do her best to get through. Not working out right now. And just go with one more through, and that's another grand slam, bringing them up to 87 for Denver.
Wow, there was a huge gap. It looked like the Grand Canyon, basically. There was a giant gap. Blast Unicorn took advantage of that and rode that hole all the way through.
When she finally got through, she got a big cheer from the underdog fan contingent here. There's a whole group of folks that seem to be, you know what, whoever is ranked lower, whoever is seems to be needing the help, I'm going to cheer for them. And that's what I like about RollerCon.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, that's what I like about roller derby in general. But definitely here at RollerCon, I think everybody's like, well, geez, I love all these teams because they are all badass teams full of badass women with badass strategy. So who can I cheer for if I love both these teams? Well, I'm going to go for the underdog.
Mel Mangles for the Wheels of Justice.
And Amanda Sharpless for Denver.
Amanda gets through.
But she knew I was saying her name.
Nice little push out there. So Mel Mangles has to re-enter in the right in the middle of the pack. And goes around the outside and finally does get through. Amanda Sharpless gets past, gets 5 points, and that'll be the end of that jam, bringing Denver up to 96. Rose City at 29, 7:50 remaining.
Now again, folks, we do have to remind you that there are two full-time tracks going on right now. We are on the full WFCDA sanction bout, but right next door it is a one-hour-long challenge. So if you do hear whistles and you don't see the pack stop, that's because it's bleeding over from the next room. But that's what's so awesome about RollerCon is that there's two full tracks at all times. And what's so awesome about the Denver Roller Dolls is that they once again got lead jammer, courtesy of Sandrine Rengon.
And about three quarters of the way around the track already, and just starting to make her scoring pass, cuts around the outside, and there you go. 4 points there. Almost caught up now with number 21, Untamed Shrew, jamming for Rose City. Tries to cut in the inside and calls it off.
Did she get that point?
She did, 3 on that pass.
29 on the board for Rose City, 103 for Denver. And it looks like we have a skater who is trying to take an intentional minor right there.
That's right.
Looking to pick up her 4th penalty. And for those of you that are newer to derby, that's one of the strategies that was invented, you know, in the last year or two when the game got a lot more cerebral than it was when it first began. And that's so that she could clear out her penalty cachet and she will be available to jam sometime soon. That was Amanda Sharpless in the penalty box. But we do have a lead jammer right here, right now. Number 5, Mel Mangles for Portland's Rose City Rollers.
However, just about a third of the track behind her, Denver's jammer coming up. Number 303, Heather Juska. But Mel calls it off.
And it looks like she's going to get those box points, correct, John Mandy? I can't see Wanton Rebellion.
Looks like she got the 2, so yep.
Wanton Rebellion is the jam ref, and so I was trying to case out her hands, but it kind of gets lost in the sea of people.
Yep.
We are rather high up here in the Derby News Network castle in the sky.
All right. Next up, number 21, Untamed Shrew, up for the Wheels of Justice, for those of you just joining again. This is the Portland, Oregon Rose City Rollers. They are in purple. But this time, Denver, number 24, Sandrine Rajon, is your lead jammer. Denver in the black and white, or white and black.
Good offense there, Sarah Sarelson.
Call is made. The track is done. 3 more points for Denver. Now up to 106. Rose City 31. 5 minutes remain in the first half.
Now Mangles back on the line for Rose City.
That was Julie Adams for Denver. 3-on-3 in the back.
Looks like Julie Adams.
Yep, Julie
up.
Adams, number 19.
That's right, for Denver.
Mile High Club, MHC.
And if she would just move, I could see the Portland Jammer. I know
that's five.
Oh,
that's
go.
Mel Mangles.
That's right.
I could sense it. Julie Adams is lead jammer, though, for Denver.
Rose City trying to create a wall in front to slow down the progress of those Denver skaters. And Julie Adams, oh, just cuts through and picks up the grand slam. Amanda Sharpless has returned from the box, rejoining the pack, giving some much-needed defensive ability here. And cuts through for one more, picking up 4 more points, and calling off the jam. Denver now at 1-1-5, Rose at 3-1. 3 minutes, 47 seconds remaining. Good enough for 2, maybe 3 more jams here in this first half. Number 21, Untamed Shrew, on the line for Rose City.
And that's 303. That's Heather Juska on the line for Denver. That's true. He looked at me and said, yep, that's true.
I cannot find fault in anything you said.
She can also find no fault on Heather Juska.
In her skating, absolutely not. There she goes, lead jam. And already approaching the rear of the pack. Took her about 17 seconds to start the jam, get lead jammer, and start her scoring pass. And with an additional 10 seconds, gets through, picks up the entire grand slam, all 5 points that were available to her. One more time, this time a little more physical. And does make it through, picks up another grand slam, another 5 points, bringing them up to 125. And just about to go one more time. She still has over a minute left in this jam.
So we're going to get at least one full jam in after this one, of course.
And one more pass.
Pass, wow. Penny Dreadful.
There's some great, great speed and skating ability here. Nice attempt at a side hit. Slowed her down, but did not stop her. She's at the back of the pack now and decides to call it off. And she seems to be holding her chin there. This is getting a little rough, but they can take it, I'm sure.
They do play roller derby. They are used to getting hit. So Denver's going to start 3 blockers on the track, as I believe it's Shayna Sarrelson. Sorry if I butcher your names, ladies. You know I love you. Is starting in the penalty box. 31 on the board for Rose City, 133 for Denver. This will probably be the last jam of the period before we go to halftime. 127 left on the game clock.
Joyride at the back of the pack, trying to force her way through, kind of physically push through. Tries to cut around the outside, inside. Goes around to the outside.
I believe you were right. The outside inside is exactly what she did. She went out, in, and then back out again.
But Denver is doing a great job of recycling their blockers, just bring them from out of nowhere, it seems, and all of a sudden, there's a 3-wall in front.
Well, and now Ariel Quigley is also headed to the penalty box. She's going to have to wait because another one of her teammates went to the box first, and Denver's box is full, so this is perfect timing for Joyride to have a joyous ride all around the track, picking up point after point after point. In fact, you just got 5 of them, John Madden.
That's right. Grand slam for Rose City. Definitely needed points there. Brings them up to 36, and another pass begins. Oh,
beautiful.
Makes it. She makes it.
Skipped, hopped, and jumped. Almost called it. Rob Lobster said, the hell you do. Keep that going, girl. Good call, Rob Lobster. Aces, bench coach.
One more pass.
She's got Mercy to help her out at the front of the pack. Mercy's going to drop back and try to trap the Denver blocker.
Pushed out by 307, Shayna Sarrelson. And decides that's it. Going to call that one off there. And looks like no, we are not going to have any timeouts called. So
we go to the halftime, it looks like, John Madding.
That's right. Rose is at 45, Denver at 133, a pretty commanding lead. But as we know, things can change at the drop of a hat, at the drop of a skate.
At the drop of a helmet cover.
14:45 remaining in halftime. We will be back in just a short while.
And actually, if you guys want to watch the halftime show, what's going on is there have been raffles all week. We've been selling raffle tickets here at RollerCon all week long, raising money for a local Girl Scouts chapter, which is really awesome. They actually came here and did a field trip the other day,
entire troop. That. That's fantastic.
Yeah, like 13 to 17-year-old girls that are still in Girl Scouts in Las Vegas. So they are high-risk youth, actually. It's a high-risk youth group. And they came in here, and they got to see every part of roller derby. They got to watch bouts. They got to watch how all the behind-the-scenes stuff happens. And so everything from here is going to be benefiting them. The grand prize, have you heard about this?
Yeah, and I mean, I bought tickets. I bought like 20 tickets just to make sure
that
I have a chance.
I didn't know that they stopped selling tickets like an hour ago. Somebody was like, so did you get tickets, Val? You always win these raffle things. And I was like, damn it.
So, yeah, the grand prize is a trip
to RollerCon Australia, courtesy of Crazy Skates.
Wow.
And I mean, there's so many other awesome prizes. I know that derby skins, you know I love me some derby skins.
Of course.
They offered $1,000 worth of uniforms they will custom make for you.
Very
Are you
nice.
Kidding me?
That's fantastic.
Are you kidding me? I'm really praying the one ticket that I have in my fanny pack, in my RollerCon fanny pack, is the one that gets me $1,000 worth of uniforms, because I just switched home team, so I can always use a new uniform.
That's true.
And I skate on all these pickup fun teams like Coed Cripplers, so wow, wouldn't that be great to have like a whole closet full of uniforms? Or you could do your whole team. It's so awesome.
Yeah, I saw this, and it's not just, you know, there's a ton of great prizes that are going on, but just the ability to support the Girl Scouts, which is one of my favorite organizations in the world.
That's exactly right.
And it, you know, I get a lot better return on my investment for that $20 in tickets that I take. Even if I win nothing.
Even if you win nothing, it doesn't matter.
Then
you already
throwing
won.
It away in the casino, yep. Which I've already done yep. quite a bit this weekend as well.
It's so, so much better because you're automatically, you know that $20 is going to something good.
So we have the big brass cylinder out here. And it's just sitting there. I would think in Vegas there'd be a lot more security around it. Back at Minnesota, when we have the coveted golden skate out, we have uniformed security watching that. Well, I mean, they're just people.
Well, I don't
suits,
think anybody's
but.
Too worried about it because it's all full of tickets to say John Madding and Val Capone.
I certainly hope so. Wouldn't it be great? You and I went down to RollerCon. I mean,
I'm planning on it. Yeah. I'm finding a way. I'm going to stop eating so I can afford the airfare, because when I went to Australia this past February with AJ, it was on a buddy pass on United Airlines, so we could afford to go, and nice. Adelaide Roller Derby took care of us, and so they could get two of us for the price of one,
Very cool.
It was a bargain. And we both have the same given name, so it's like the same person, really, except for she's a far better skater than I am, and I'm a little bit funnier than she is, so it worked out great.
There you go.
But RollerCon Australia, it's going to be November 30th through December 2nd. I'm so, so, so excited. I cannot wait to go back to the land down under, and I cannot wait to see the passion of the Australian roller derby, all the skaters from New Zealand and Australia and Tasmania. There are so many of them that come here each and every year. I mean, there's almost always at least one Australian team represented here. But we're going to get the raffle going right now. Rockets Ron is gonna do this right with Ivana Espankin. You may or may not have heard of her. I don't know. Do you live under a rock? Well, she is the founder and creator and the kingpin of RollerCon, so I'm going to let her do the talking.
So, before we get started with the final of the grand prize raffle draws, I just want to thank everyone who bought tickets, because it's a really, really good cause. This raffle, as you can see, we've got a ton of tickets in here, which means that we raised a ton of money for the Girl Scout drop in centers. And thank you for that. Now, do you guys know what our prizes are? Alright, our third prize is a ticket to next year's RollerCon. And a hotel.
I want that.
Me too.
I want a free ticket. Wait, I already got one because I'm a manager. But I'll take the free hotel room.
Oh, absolutely.
You can have my ticket. I'll take the hotel. You could sleep on the street.
It doesn't really seem like they care, though. They're so quiet.
hotel.
Oh boy. Val is jumping up and down on this balcony. I'm afraid.
Afraid of whether or not the balcony can hold us or my sports bra can hold me.
Actually, more of the latter, my dear. Rakus Ron of the Kansas City Roller Warriors announcing team is helping Ivana out.
Kansas City Roller Warriors. I love those ladies. All right, Ivana, pick our tickets. Me and John want free hotels.
This is the third place prize.
That's a really cool prize when you think about it, because even if you get it on Black Friday, that's still like $100.
Third prize, which is
RollerCon 2013 pass. It's a minimum of $100. And a four-night stay here.
Number 472-257. And that's Cindy Opkin. Cindy, are you here?
Cindy Opkin. Oh, she's not here. Oh, boy. Well, I think they should just draw another one and give it to us.
I think they should just say she's not here and give it to us.
Oh, is that her? Oh, they're calling her. There's a friend of hers that is calling her on her phone. This is one of the must be present to win ones, I guess.
Yeah, for any
all
of the
raffles, you didn't have to be present to win.
There you go. Yep. Thank you, Ivana.
Her friend is trying. Well, two of her friends are trying to. One of you should hang up because.
Yeah, this isn't a radio show contest for New Kids on the Block tickets, ladies.
Derby skins. We talked about that before. $1,000 worth of derby skins to create uniforms for you, your friends, whoever.
For second place, a $1,000 gift certificate for derby skins uniforms for your entire team.
That's a big gift certificate. Goodness gracious. It's like one of them.
I want that.
One of them fake checks.
I don't even care if I get the uniforms.
Hanging up in here.
I just want it. I wanted to use it as my blanket. It's a giant banner that says awesome things.
I want to hang it up behind my desk at work and have people come in.
Val Capone. John, if you get this, I'm stealing it from you.
My wife might fight you on that.
No, she'll lose. I love your wife. But I'm
6-3.
Val Capone.
Damn
it.
Harry Carey?
Oh, hey, everybody.
Holy cow.
Hey. Hey, if you were a derby player, would you wear derby skins? I would. Sorry, that was the best I can do after four days of RollerCon. Hey.
Or maybe it's Carey? That would be a,
hey,
be a good
derby,
derby
skins.
Name.
A one.
And if,
a two.
If her name is
skins.
If her name is Carey.
You better do cartwheels.
Oh no! This is a.
I know. I want this.
Case.
Stop talking.
Nope. Sorry.
Stop talking. Oh. You're fired. I'm the meanest.
Also a crazy skates distributor. And I'm Alice, crazy skates opinion, basically. Okay. So Hot Wheels, can you do a drop for us?
Hot Wheels, can you pick my name, please? I want to go to Australia.
Oh, an MVP pass, too.
I will
fantastic.
Donate that to you.
So I can learn to skate.
Yes. You need it, brother.
Oh, boy, do I.
Also, there's announcing classes. I suggest you sign up quickly.
You had me teach one with you today. What the hell?
That's because I was feeling sorry. Good day. I'm seriously going to pee myself. No,
Michelle,
you read it wrong.
Williamson.
It says Val Capone.
It's written Michelle Williamson, but it's pronounced Val Capone.
Oh, that's in Australian. My name is Michelle Williamson in Australian. I forgot. We don't always all speak Australian.
Wouldn't that be terrible
although
if all three of them were not here?
What?
Oh.
Oh my God, she's one of the EMTs. All right.
Oh
that's
my
allowed.
Goodness, that works.
That is allowed.
That works.
That is awesome because these EMTs, can, she has
let's,
no
let's
idea.
Move over to, let's move over here and see her. Oh, we can't.
Is that her?
Well, that was just a poor idea all around.
She has no idea. She's working as an EMT right now, and she just got a free trip to Australia. She has no idea.
They're coming
She's
up to
freaking
her.
Out.
Oh, there we go. We do have a winner of the Derby Skins gift certificate. So I think only the number three prize has not been fully awarded yet.
Hey, towards the Chicago Cubs.
Well, yeah, someone named Carrie Carey is probably a Cubs fan, so
or she just really has to wax a lot. I don't know. I mean, I'm not going to be rude. I'm not about to ask her those questions, John. Oh, my God. Somebody is jumping up and down, freaking out, calling people on the phone about the trip to Australia. If she took her break, if she's, oh, my God, the one medic is saying that she's sleeping.
No.
No, they have to give that. They have to give
you
it to her.
You have to give it to the medic.
You have to give it to the medic. Let's break the rules. I'll take the major penalty. I will stay late.
Cindy has one more minute to get here. Otherwise, we're going to draw again.
I'm going to throw up. If she doesn't get that Australian trip, then there is no justice in the world. And I have met Justice Fielder Marshall. I know there is justice in the world.
I have seen the wheels of justice.
We're watching the wheels of justice.
Are you guys Cindy's friends? Are you guys Cindy's friends? Why don't you just pretend to be her?
Duh. Everybody's been doing that with each other's jerseys all week anyway.
Is she on the way?
She's not on the way.
Andale, andale.
All right. Who thinks we should redraw?
Oh. We have a mixture of yays and boos. Okay, all right. I think Cindy's getting this.
I'm kind of on the side of the Cindy people. I sort of feel like I would suck if you wanted to make that take
I love roller derby.
Okay, I think now her friend, she has 15 minutes, so her friends are going to run out and attempt to find her.
Her friends better be able to stay in this free hotel room that
oh,
she's winning.
Oh, boy, they had better.
Yeah, a running EMT with no injuries. Actually, miss, no running. I was just kidding.
No, you can Whoops. Run. You're allowed to run.
You're allowed to run. It's the only time that you were allowed to. I've been telling people, no running, please.
No running, no running.
Although I got to be honest, I was running back and forth between the announcer suites.
We'll meet them over there by the scoreboard. Thanks, guys. Thanks for being so awesome about our charity.
All right, that was pretty cool.
That was not enjoyable at all. What are you talking about? That made me angry. Well, I want to go do taxes.
You bought one ticket.
I didn't buy a ticket.
Oh,
actually.
You didn't buy a ticket?
I got one for my volunteer shift.
Okay, then you have one ticket.
I was supposed to get five tickets.
I had 20.
Well, congratulations.
So I had 20
times
the chance.
You are a Samaritan and a saint.
No, I'm just saying I should be 20 times as angry as you.
No,
I?
I'm not angry. I'm stoked about life. Have you ever met me? I'm always like, oh my God, life is awesome. Totally. No, I'm very excited about that. I'm actually joking. I've been super lucky. And last year I won bearings.
Oh,
and
cool.
Actually the skates that I skate on in 2007, I won them at the Dust Devil. Actually 2006, I'm sorry. Was it the first or the second? Boy, so many concussions, I can't recall. But, you know, they've been rocking with me for years. And it was because of the first junior derby league that ever started, the Tucson Derby Brats, were doing a fundraiser. And I literally had $20 left to my name. And I was going to use it for the after party to get drunk. Because I'm good like that.
But then you can tell stories about how you don't have any money because you were supporting the Derby Brats and people
would
buy you free drinks.
I had these little kids that were like, yeah. Hey, Val Capone, you're doing security. I'm pulling on your security shirt. Can you buy tickets or can you help us song? You're really loud. And I was like, I am really loud. And I don't really need to get drunk on this. I'd rather support the future of roller derby.
Absolutely.
So I bought a slew of tickets. And Quicksilver skated over to me, a referee from Texas. She goes, hey, Val, you think you got enough tickets there? Because it was literally as long as I am. And, you know, I'm almost 5'10", trying to get on the Amazons next year. And she was like, you think you got enough tickets? I was like, but Quicksilver, this one right here, this is the winner. So I tore it. And she was like, okay, Val, nice knowing you. Skates away. They called the number. It wasn't me. And I was all bummed. I was like, whatever. I supported roller derby. Then that person never showed. Later on in the day, like maybe, I don't know, half hour later, they decided to call again. And that's how I won the my skates.
Very cool.
Because you were selfless. You contributed to Girl Scouts. And I was selfless and contributed to Tucson. So what you won was this really long, stupid, pointless story.
Yeah.
Congratulations,
I'm
John.
I'm used to that from you, dear.
That's true. Yeah. We have known each other a long time.
Yeah, so you're pretty much directly responsible for Ole's newest standout, Lindsay Lobo.
What's that?
Because Lindsay started out in the Tucson Derby, graduated.
Yes.
Up to.
And
up
she
to
skated on my jocks team.
There you
and
go.
She wasn't feeling good. She was feeling sick. She almost didn't skate. And I was like, Lindsay, I need you. You're a great skater with a great attitude, and you're really fun. I need to coach you. I need to yell at you. And she said, okay, Val, you can yell at me. And she did great. Anytime her boyfriend Speed ended up in the penalty box, she was the one that like fixed the situation by getting a million points on the track. It was great.
That's hilarious.
Yes.
No, she's great. She came up and played with the rest of Tucson last spring. Two springs ago when they played Minnesota, and she had just turned 18. So,
wow.
Of course, she couldn't go to the after party and was very bummed about that.
Yeah.
But she was really a standout skater, and Ole is very, very lucky to have her.
Yeah, she's great. And she's, like I said, she's quite agreeable, very easy to work with. And she was, like, sick to her stomach. Mm-hmm. And I even told her, I was like, sweetheart, just go sit at the end of the bench. Whenever you're feeling good, you just let me know. And she's like, why? I was like, because you're not feeling well. She's like, well, I'll deal with that. By the time it's my turn to skate, I'll be fine.
That's a great attitude.
Yeah, and we were down, actually. The Nerds had the lead, and I was like, are you sure you want this? It's going to get really intense. And she said, Val, yes, I want this. And I was like, yes. Roller derby. Back to the action on the track. We have Mel Mangles is lining up to wear the star for Portland.
That's right. In a power jam position, we do have all three seats taken up by Denver. The minivan situation in favor of Rose City. They're down by 92 points.
Look, we have a little bit of love from, I believe, some ladies from Hawaii. They're in the skybox right next to us. They're saying, aloha, wits and ass. Lovely.
Which one of us is wits and which one of us is ass?
Yeah, they weren't talking to us. They were probably
what?
Talking to one of their friends.
No,
but I'm going
to
go.
They must be talking to us.
I'm ass and you're wits.
All right. Or, well, you know, it can be the other way around.
Yeah, I'm
we
pretty
can,
sure
we
it is.
Trade. We can trade off between jams.
Okay. All right. This is my jam to be wits, so watch out. Beware of puns. Or would that be ass? Mel Mangles is pushing the envelope. She's going to get past because they're going to have to let her go, and she did get lead jammer, John Manning.
That's right. Here she goes, trying to just jump up here, get as many points as humanly possible while on that power jam. Ooh, just gets knocked out. Very, very close, and Denver retreats, gets sent off. Number 99, Tracy Akers, the last one. So Mel comes through again. Oh, gets pushed out that time by Christiana Barrett, but eventually does get through. Oh, but then a major track
Mel Mangles
cut.
Is not happy. She's pointing at the ref, pointing at the pack, pointing back at the ref. Well, guess what? He's pointing at you, saying, go to the penalty box. Unfortunately, you cut the track.
And while that was happening, Amanda Sharpless did come out of the box. So that is going to be a full minute in the box for Mel. Sharp was just getting by. Number 210, Heidi Go Seek.
You know,
picks up that grand slam.
John, what it looks like right now, the way people are positioned randomly just standing there throughout the track, it looks like a diagram of how derby should be played. When you can't actually move the drawings,
yeah.
That's what that just looked like. Sharpless stays in bounds.
It's another grand slam, another 5 points adding to that lead. Denver now 98 points ahead of Rose City.
And the crowd starts to chant MHC, MHC, Mile High Club, of course. Out again. How many points did she get on that last pass, John?
Another five, and they pass 100 points over Rose, bringing up to a 103 margin of victory right now. But Mel Mangles, was trying to correct when she came in. She was going a little too hot and tried to slow down, but ended up falling.
It looks like Ionic Bondage is the girl who won the trip to Australia because she's holding hands right now with Hot Wheels, and it looks like they're talking about everything Australian. And she's looking very, very, like she's having difficulty breathing in the best of ways.
Excellent.
She's
excellent.
Just kind of fanning herself as they walk, and she's very excited.
She's shaking.
And Raucous Ron was walking in front of them and kind of caught our attention and looked like he was about ready to cry. But back on the track, 49 on the board for Rose City, 150 for Denver, 27-21 left to go. Both teams at full staff. And two completely split packs, John.
Yep, Denver bust through here. Number 303, Heather Juska, has become your lead jammer and is now making her scoring pass. 17H, the Blast Unicorn, still trying to get through, having a bit of trouble up at the front from Jess Rivas. But while that was all happening, once again, Juska grabs a fiver. And around slaloming a bit, and it stopped by the small wall up in front. Rose City tries to reform. Oh, one, two hit, three hits.
Nice big hit right there.
But stays inbounds and on her skates. Excellent, excellent skate control.
Yeah, and Brady Punch followed her almost all the way out of bounds, but excuse me, out of the zone of engagement. Had to let her go, though, because she was in danger of getting an out-of-play penalty. Picked up five more points for Denver.
That
Heather Juska.
Trying one more time. Gets past one, gets pushed back, gets past two. Coming around before the straight. Oh, gets pushed out. Scrappy-go-lucky stays in, so that forces her to call it off. Denver adds more, and Denver's at 164 to Rose City's 49.
Wow, Tracy Akers. I don't know if you guys caught that at home. Somebody was trying to get the dance party started on the jam line. She put her knees down, and booty, booty, booty was rocking everywhere.
Sandrine Rajon is jamming for Mile High Club up against number 21, Untamed Shrew, for Portland. Now, keep in mind, for those of you just joining us, Denver E is wearing the white tops and helmets with the black leggings, while Rose City is wearing purple and white.
Denver just driving it hard.
Playing very physically, trying to get them beat up a little bit and wear them down. That's the only way they seem to be able to be stopping these Denver skaters, not enforcing penalties.
Untamed Shrew is out and eligible to score points. However, Sandrine did pick up 5 points. Excuse me, 4 points on that last pass.
And Sandrine showing some excellent speed there, coming right up against, up behind Shrew. Shrew jumps a little bit ahead, picks up one. But also, Sandrine picks up one as well. So right now, with 24 minutes, 36 seconds remaining, Rose City trails 51 to Denver's 169. It looks like we've got Joyride on the line for Rose City up against Amanda Sharpless for the Mile High Club. Ooh, a bit of a domino action there.
Everybody did fall down. Domino rallied, though, because she was able to get out of that pack.
Joyride, there she goes.
Yeah, going on a joyride, getting lead jammer status. Out of the pack, almost, is Sharpless. She's got one blocker left. She gets past out of the pack. Each team has at least one person in the penalty box.
Joyride has made it through, picks up the four, and calls it off.
That's a smart call, John. Sharpless was about to hit the back of the pack. And even though Portland was at the front, it's still too risky to do that.
That's
call
right.
It, stop it. Don't let the bleeding continue.
That's right. When you're behind by nearly 120 points, you don't want to drain that clock too much.
Well, that's
much.
Only 114.
You need I said nearly.
Oh my God, I just did math.
It's new for you, isn't it?
A whole new world.
We'll probably have to pay BMI fees if we do that anymore.
Yes, that's so true. Sorry, okay, let's stop. Heather Juska is jamming for Denver, and I believe that is the Blast Unicorn blasted through.
Very nice, very nice. A lot of speed there. Juska right behind her. Now, this is looking like almost an Ole versus Ole match here with that kind of speed and that low, low stance there.
That's a 0-0 jam, John. She did get lead jammer and called it to protect her team's points, of course.
Score remains 55-169 in favor of Denver. 22:45 to go.
Oh, I got confused. Those were the whistles on the other track.
Yeah, we have. You can't see it, but there's an open air wall. It's got both the door that goes into the other track, but also a wide open space so the DNN cameras can be taking a look at both of these tracks. And we have a Rose City lead jam. That's one more time. It's Joyride again, doing very, very good things for the Rose City Rollers here.
Yeah, getting lead jammer, two jams literally in a row.
Right behind her, Sandrine Rajon. She gets through.
Nice work on the part of Joyride. Let's see how many points she got.
Looks like she picked up the three.
Yep.
She picked up all three and called it.
Way to read fingers, John.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
They're very far away.
They are very far away.
I am getting older.
Older? You're already old, my friend. Said with love. So it looks like Mel Mangles is hanging out by the jam line. She's hugging her teammate, the Blast Unicorn. She's probably most likely there to pick up her fourth minor intentionally, of course.
Because if she wasn't, that would be a silly place to hang out.
That would be awkward, yes.
Sharpless on the line for Denver.
One Denver skater in the sin bin. All the purple at the front of the pack. Denver is just kind of hanging out.
And it begins. Sharpless goes around the outside of her own pack, tries to cut through the inside, spins around 360, gets through. Sharpless, lead jammer for Denver. Last Unicorn having some trouble, gets pushed out, has to go all the way to the back of the pack and re-enter between turns two and three. Gets pulled down by her own teammate, Monica Carlson does. But Last Unicorn has made it through and is now able to score points if Sharpless lets her, but she won't. So she'll call it off after getting a nice little whip from Ariel Quigley. So Rose City remains at 58, Denver at 174, 20 and a half minutes to go. Untamed Shrew on the line for Rose City up against Heather Jiska for Denver. Jiska pops through that back wall there created by Denver. Shrew working her way through, but Jiska does make it through first. Comes lead jammer. Shrew now having to deal with Tracy Akers up at the front of that pack. Oh, Akers, wow. Akers, a one-woman wall, is using that booty to hold her back.
I told you, she's booty, 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 blocking everywhere. That's what she does. She always wins the after party, and she'll win a booty fight on the track, too.
About two-thirds of the track, she was holding Shrew back, all on her lonesome.
Scrappy-go-lucky, unfortunately, going to the penalty box right before the end of the jam. 19:20 on the clock, 58 for Rose, 177 for Denver.
Sandrine Rajon again for Denver.
We can't quite see who the lady in purple is.
Looks like that might be Joyride again. And if they're gonna have to rely on somebody, she's a good one to rely on. She's been doing nothing but good stuff this whole game here.
I think Joe Mama just died. Joe Mama and Tara Armoff are rocking the house call on this. Lee Jammer goes to Denver. Not quite sure what kind of bird noises he was making, but he was very excited when everybody decided to play derby and actually move.
Ranjan on the back of the pack. Trying to cut around the outside. Oh, big flip down there by 73.
Frankenherter.
She's okay. Gets right back up.
Grand slam for Denver Roller Dolls.
And Ryan Jones about to make her second pass through. Around gets pushed out a good 30 feet. Has to return. And goes around the outside and picks it up. Another grand slam for Denver. Siley Devour going to take a seat for Rose City. She's been doing a good job of holding back Denver and kind of splitting their pack for the whole game. One more time through. Once again, Sandrine Rajon. Another five big points.
She still has 25 seconds. She could get another lap and help get Denver closer to breaking the double century mark, 200 points, as they are currently at the 192, oh. John.
She just ducked under that foremost Rose City player. Scrappy go lucky there.
58 on the board for Rose, 197 for Denver. And the jam expires.
No, she called it off.
Oh,
she was looking.
Right as the jam clock ticked up.
Oh, it was? Okay, great. I was watching
Love
her. You were watching the clock. Fantastic.
Look at us. Eyes are everywhere. So, as I said, it's 58-197 in the favor of Denver. 16:45 left on the clock, John.
That's right. Looks like number five for the Wheels of Justice. That is Mel Mangles.
And Amanda Sharpless back out there for Denver through the thick of the fire. Mel Mangles with a huge smile on her face gets lead jammer for Rose.
Rose does hold back Sharpless enough to, she's about a half track behind Mel Mangles. Mel Mangles going to grab through here, try to get past these two. Does it, picks up the ghost points. Good 4 points. For Rose City, and the crowd is really, really getting behind Rose City here.
And Mel Mangles went on one skate, and she looked like, I am so happy, just clapping for the crowd, clapping along with the crowd, I should say. Excellent, excellent work, Mel Mangles. And it's all that kind of positivity, that's what keeps us all coming back. Let's be honest, this is probably an insurmountable hill for them to climb, but why not have a good time doing so and learning something from this experience?
Absolutely. Both of these teams are going to be at the Western Regionals beginning in just 2 months.
Hosted by Bay Area, correct?
Yes, I believe, but not in Oakland. Somewhere, I think, to the north of Oakland.
Somewhere over the rainbow. That's Untamed Shrew taken out, number four. Jess Rivas. Juska gets out, though, and she gets lead jammer for DRD once again.
So both these teams are going to learn take what they learn from these games that they're playing this weekend and apply them over the next 2 months to be the best they can be during the Big Five. Because both of these teams have a really, really good shot at going to WFTDA championships.
Juska gets out, and she's going to call it. So Rockus Ron is doing a couple little shout-outs on the track right now. But you know what I would like to do? I would give a special shout-out. There are some ladies from Bogota that are here at RollerCon.
What?
Oh, man. That makes me so excited. No, Rock and Roller Queens from Colombia. And I got that from Mr. Rock himself. Perhaps he's a little biased because his name is Rock and they rock. But they are spelled differently, so it is not the same, by the way. But welcome, welcome, welcome to RollerCon, and welcome to all of you listening at home from Bogota, Colombia. That makes me so excited that somebody's listening to me and John babble about Derby for quite a few hours today.
Now we have to be international hosts. Nice run through here. Number five for Rose City. That's Mel Mangles, and she is the jammer. Rose holding back Denver's jammer, Sandrine Rajon. Fantastic. It's really great to see that the Rose City Rollers are just doing an excellent job of just keep on keeping on. They know that they are behind by a good nearly over 150 points here.
It's only 13 minutes to play, but they are playing like they're 2 points behind. It's always good to see that that kind of never give up attitude, no matter how far behind you are. Well, this time goes down on all fours, but gets right back up as she passed the foremost blocker for Rose City. Sharpless took a bit of a trip, but got right back up.
Blast Unicorn being held at the back of the pack by that two wall from Denver. Pack is very, very spread out. Swiss Cheese City on the track. Sharpless does get through. She picks up 5 more points for Denver. There's still 12 minutes and 20 seconds left in the second period. Sharpless around again. Let's see how many points she got on this last pass. That's another 5. Blast is still stuck in the back. She's looking a little bit tired, I'm not going to lie. She's just getting her helmet handed to her, if you will.
But she really narrowly saved herself from getting a major track cut there.
She sure did.
So still has that presence of mind to just watch her feet, watch where she went in, watch who pushed her out.
What's great about Blast is even though she was getting roughed up, so physically she might be tired, she had that mental awareness, which is what is key. Unfortunately, she didn't have offense right at that moment to get her out, but she did have the wherewithal to avoid that track cut. So nice work, Blast Unicorn.
5 on 5 on the floor. Jessica on the line for the Mile High Club up against Mel Mangles for the Wheels of Justice. Denver Mile High Club in the white and black. And the Rose City Rollers, Wheels of Justice in the purple. Now, I want to give a shout out myself because I also have someone from South America that.
Oh.
Yes.
You're a fancy lad.
Lily McVicious came all the way up from Brazil, the Ladies of Helltown, one of the two teams in Sao Paulo, Brazil.
Actually, yeah. Was she the one that was at the announcing class?
That's right. That's right.
Yes.
Sent me a hug from Derby Munster, who's the head of that league. I met quite a few of the girls of Team Brazil at the World Cup last year.
Oh, they were amazing.
Fantastic. Just is having a real tough time with those Rose City girls up at the front
even though they are down, they are not out of this fight. And I mean that they are down in points, but they are not out of this fight. They are throwing down on the track. Just having a hell of a time getting past Mercy.
150 points down as of now, and that adds another 5. Denver now at 220. Rose City.
Speaking
65.
Of 210 went to the penalty box for Wheels of Justice. That's Heidi Goseek.
And that time, Jessica got through quite a bit easier. Picked up another grand slam, bringing up to 225. Rose City's 65. Oh, and again. Okay, that time she just decided I'm not even gonna try it. I'll just go through. I'll take the minor track cut. So just so I can get some forward momentum. Blast Unicorn.
Just because trying to call it. She was sitting down doing some yoga in the turn.
But 0 points that time for Rose City. Remaining at 65. Denver at 227. 9 minutes, 23 seconds remaining in the game. Yeah, what's really cool too is riding elevators and hearing a bunch of different languages. Here, it's fantastic. It's they're just talking about.
Are you
Derby,
having sci-fi dreams again?
Absolutely not. I heard Spanish. I heard Portuguese.
Yep.
I heard French. I
heard English.
I haven't heard that yet.
No, I mean like girls from England.
Oh, I get it.
Yeah.
Oh, a nice little apex jump there.
No Mangles. That's all she knows how to do is nice derby, my friends. Look at how stoked she is. She does not care what the scoreboard says. She just only cares that people are stoked as she is.
And the crowd is going wild for her. That's fantastic.
I love Mel Mangles because she always has the best attitude. And look at her calling the jam, calling it. Treated you. Oh! She is stoked. And that is not a diss on Denver. That is a fist pump for her and her team.
Absolutely. Shutting them down that time. Rose City now up to 69. Denver 230. 8 minutes, 16 seconds remaining in the game.
So now the jammers are going to be released. Is that Mel Mangles back
is.
Out on the track?
It's
Why
Mel
wouldn't
again.
You? She's like, screw this. Yeah. I want to jam a lot.
I want to do this again.
I'm going to jam me a lot.
She's going up against Sandrine Rajon for Denver. Mangles still stuck up at the back. Sandrine comes through the front and gets it.
Yeah, Mercy Sandrine tried Rajon. To bridge, but they had to let her go. Mel Mangles gets taken out, but the skater that took her out went down. Up. Yep,
oh,
she's definitely going to get that cut.
Go.
She unfortunately passed a few of her players.
Yep.
So.
And she's nodding her head. Yep, yep, I did it.
She's
you
like,
me.
That's cool. I'm having fun. I don't know if you saw me hump the air. Clearly, I'm just here to have fun at this point.
And, of course, this is nearly a full house here right now.
Even Rob Lobster is smiling and laughing.
Yeah.
And when it's this kind of a point deficit, that's kind of all you can do is just be proud of the small accomplishments that happen on the track.
That's true. So for those of you that are watching up in your hotel rooms, now's the time to hit the bar so all these folks that are about to leave don't get in front of you.
Go get your blue and your black on, and also your drunk and your drank on. But make sure you hydrate.
Absolutely. I've been drinking so much water this weekend. It's ridiculous. I've never spent this much time in the desert.
Yeah, you're from Minnesota, the land of 10,000 lakes.
That's right, you know.
Woofta. 73 is going to have to let her go. Sorry.
Rajon with the grand slam. And beginning another scoring pass. 6.5 minutes.
Oh, look. And here comes Mel Mangles ready to have some more fun. Mercy is trying to bridge the two groups together. There goes Mel power blasting through the white. Can she get through? Mercy's going to back bridge. I like that. I like the good back bridge. Mel Mangles goes again, gets a minor track cut. Wow, what is going on? Are they wrestling up there? Or are they dancing? Or are they doing?
I'm really not sure. Good. Oh, nice, nice knockout there.
Mel Mingles gets through. How many points did she get? We're going to have to take a look and see.
Oh, she got zero. And she's
boo
not too happy
Werns.
About that.
I'm not booing Julius Pleaser in his call. I'm boo Wernsing the fact that she didn't score any points. But look it. I think she wants to go for more. So she's going to send out Untamed Shrew.
And she's going to take on Jiska.
Yep.
260 to 69, 5.5 minutes to go.
She's so stoked on the bench right now. It's ridiculous. Untamed Shrew trying to fight on through that little scrum start.
Kind of fighting her way through. Jiska does make it through just in the middle of turn two. Comes Lee Jammer. Begins her scoring pass on the outside, tries to cut in. Is she going to try and force her way through? But Shrew makes it through and can now start scoring points. Jiska gets four.
Untamed Shrew gets to the back of the pack and has to put the brakes on. Jessica's trying to force her way through.
Oh,
she
boy.
Does get through.
Wow.
Yeah, that was like nobody was in her way. They basically just opened the door right there for her.
Everybody's concentrating on the Shrew, either trying to stop her or trying
Everybody.
To get her, help her through. Jessica decided
Once
that
again,
she could capitalize on that.
It
one
looks
more.
Like Jiska is just roller skating at this point, not even playing roller derby.
Well, you know, when you have this much of a lead, you can really take it, you know, take advantage, take your time, see, wait until
oh,
the
I
hole
agree.
Opens up.
Yep.
And there's no reason to get hurt, to get into a
Exactly.
Fight.
It's not to risk penalties.
Yep.
No reason. And that's one of the reasons why I love Heather Jiska. First off, she's really, really nice off skates, but she also is a very stealth jammer. She's very smart. She understands the game very, very well. She knows when you should conserve or when you should crank it. But unfortunately, Untamed Shrew is going to the penalty box.
Yep.
Yeah.
Just got one more pass here. Nice little push there, and a call is made. And that's the end of that jam. 3 minutes, 40 seconds remaining. Rose City at 73 points. Denver at 285. So 200 points, 212 points separate these two teams. With just under 3.5 minutes to go. probably just two jams remaining. Julie Adams skating for Denver.
It's been a little while since Julie's worn the Jamstar, but she's back out on the track now. Mercy's baiting her back. Julie gets back to the track, tries to sneak up, hits that wall of purple. Meanwhile, her entire team is just stopped, standing there, watching her do this fight. Now they decide to go on offense. As Julie goes down with Mercy, Mercy's going to the box. Julie's back
looks
around.
Like for a low block major.
Yeah. Down goes Julie Adams once again. Gets up very quickly.
And that is actually one of Mercy's, if not her first. Is that her first major?
That might be, yeah.
She's been playing very clean for as physical as she has been. Julie Adams, one more Rose City Roller to beat, and she does. Gets the Grand Slam. Untamed Shrew has returned from the box. So now both teams are just down by one blocker apiece. Oh, and making it look easy, cutting through like a hot knife through a cliche.
Oh, I love that about you. You turn the cliche on its toes.
Mwah. Nice, nice. Right there, Untamed Shrew getting attempted to be pushed out by numerous Denver players, but stays up on one skate, stays inbounds. And again, this is down to practicing fundamentals against a very, very tough opponent, which they're going to have to do at Western Regionals in just about 2 months.
Sure, trying to get an assist from Havana in time, was able to reach for Sherwood quite in time.
Mercy has returned to the pack. Also, Denver's last blocker in the box is standing, so less than 10 seconds to go. But time has expired on that jam, so looks like we are going to have one more jam. 1 minute, 2 seconds remaining in regulation. It'll be about 40 seconds left when we start the clock, when we start the jam. Of course, that jam will go for up to 2 full minutes. Sharpless on the line for Denver for the last jam of the evening. Going up against Joyride. Joyride has just been fantastic every time she has jumped on the track today. Sharpless. Whoa, Sharpless like a lion.
Sharpless gets out and you can see she's just waiting and waiting. And look at her, she just likes to roller skate.
That's right. Takes a look back at the clock. She's going to eat up this time. She's not going to attempt anything, it looks like.
Because honestly, let the opposition do whatever they need to do, because that's a very sizable lead.
Yes.
I'm
yes.
going to point out the obvious. That lead is gigante. Sábados gigante is what that lead is. Giant Saturday.
And calls it off. And that will be that, your unofficial final. Rose City 77, Denver 306.
I'm going to go ahead unofficially and say that Denver won this
one. Well, I'm going to say that too, but I just want to make sure that the score, the score is exact. Because Lord knows what happens.
Ditka does know what happens. He is always watching.
When there might be an issue with adding scores. That never happened any time recently.
I don't know anybody
that
would happen to.
Our two favorite teams.
Weird. I have no favorites, John. I love everyone. I've never heard of anything where points needed to be added on at the end of the game. But you know what? One day it might happen.
Never
so
know.
So that's why we are saying this is an unofficial final. Until we hear the official score is correct, we're going to tell you that 77 for Rose and 306
wow.
for Denver is your unofficial final.
I noticed that quite a few of the Minnesota Roller Girls All-Stars who are going to be playing Denver tomorrow at noon were watching this. And,
so not Rocky Mountain, as my schedule for you said.
That's right.
And you kept trying to tell me 3 million times. That's weird, John. That's weird.
Yeah, Rocky Mountain actually played just on Friday.
Yep.
Two games on Friday.
I would say that they had the best schedule.
oh boy, yes.
Minnesota, you are brave ladies, man, stretching it out all 3 days. Getting a little love for the Wheels of Justice, of course.
Very excited to watch Rose City skate as Minnesota's going to be traveling out there doing the Pacific Northwest trifecta next month. taking on Rose, then Oli, then Rat. Denver, an amazing, amazing jump out here, 306-77.
Well, John, as yes, always, yes, it was a pleasure calling this game with you.
Even though we didn't win anything.
We won at life.
That's true.
We won
true.
The...
We have good lives, don't we?
We do. It's dude, I have the best life. I could get hit by a semi again, and I would still say that I have the best life. Yes, I said again.
But we would be very sad again.
So we're going to take a... Oh, look at this. Hawaii. Oh, my gosh. I love Hawaii. Aloha. I'm showing them all my aloha tattoo. I love Hawaii so much. And we love you. Thank you, Hawaii. Thank you.
Hawaii has that that awesome 808 skate.
Yeah, skate 08.
Skate 08, pardon me.
That's okay.
Gonna, that's
you're thinking
be
of the
808
group.
State.
808
yes, exactly.
State, yes. That's okay, my friend.
Coming up in January.
January, yep.
A great time to go to Hawaii.
Oh, that's when I went last time was in January, and I was excited.
Yes. Always good to escape the Midwest.
What are you talking
in
about?
In the winter.
Anyhow, now that we're all giggly and slap happy, I'm very excited. I don't have a manager's meeting tonight, so I'm going to go enjoy the black and blue ball. How about
sounds
you?
Sounds great. I think we're going to hit the Fremont Street Experience and then come back for the black and blue
exactly.
ball.
Exactly. That's exactly right.
You know, we have to.
I might go see Tenacious D and then come back.
Oh, that's true. Yeah. You have that that in, don't
I
you?
I do. A good friend of mine is Sir Trump Tech, so I'm going to go check that out and enjoy my fabulous life.
Exactly. All right. Thanks so much for all you DNN viewers.
Oh, and my life is so fabulous because of all of you. Thank you so much for the support.
And please, if you do like what you see, always contribute to DNN, bringing you the best in roller derby from all over this world of ours.
All right. Well, I believe that's going to wrap it up for this evening. Thank you so much to John Maddening for being my partner in crime, as always. High five, brother.
Ooh, and thank you to Val Capone for being just plain speechy keen.
And thank you so much to all you viewers of Derby Nation for tuning in all over the world. We'll see you guys tomorrow.
Last game of the weekend on DNN tomorrow at noon, Minnesota versus Denver. We'll see you here.
Who's an MVP for Denver?
Dirt Monkey? Really? Is that a quota thing? Oh, we put out a jammer every time. Oh, I remember. Congratulations, Dirt Monkey. MVP. You successfully fielded a jammer every time they needed one on the track.
Hey, whatever works, dude.
Great work. Thank you for all that. All right. So. interested enough to apply to be part of it. I, you know what?